All right, welcome to our short demo of our newest process assistant. We are within a demo with, of course, synthetic data that mirrors real life order to cash process. This is of an industrial vendor specializing in mechanical parts, we named it Bursair Earth Moving, and their typical process, let me just come over here, their typical process, we start with the customer inquiry and ends with a payment if everything works in an ideal scenario. We see that we have some information about different plants, we have different products, but the problem that we have when someone's looking into a report like this is, you have a lot of information and you want to know where you want to start. So you want to have some sort of assistant where you can start your analysis journey. And that's why we introduced our process assistant. It's the chat interface on the left side. And this isn't some sort of static visualization. This is directly embedded at this point in a Microsoft Power BI report, all sorts of interaction that you would have in a BI tool. But within the process system, you have the option to directly interact with the data by asking easy questions. So if I start with something real simple and say, hey, show me the cases with the most activities, it will ask the question against the underlying data to generate the answer, generate everything that we need. And in the end, you will see that it will create a filter within the report. So we are now looking at the 10 cases that have the most activities. But of course, we can do this with more complex stuff like show me only cases where we had maintenance and the cost was higher than 1200. And in the end here, we get all the cases that have maintenance and have higher cost than 1200. So 1600, 2.5. We can go to any more complex question as well. So now looking only at cases where the product was inquired, there was no payment, and we are only looking at dump trucks. So we can interact with all dimensions that we have. And of course, the fun part, we can have it on in all kinds of different languages. So we asked a question in German. And now we see, okay, the top 10 cases with the highest loop count. We see a lot of loops here, self loops here. And now from here, of course, you will just go to whatever you want to look at. Look at the KPIs or PPIs here based on the data that we just selected and go on with your process analysis journey.